Before there was a Doug Williams, there was a Joe Gilliam. Before there was a Warren Moon, Joe Gilliam was a quarterback in the National Football League. Before there was a $100 million contract for Donovan McNabb, there was a Joe Gilliam. And those guys would not have had the opportunity had there not been a Joe Gilliam.
I thought that he was the quarterback of the now and in the future of Pittsburgh. I actually looked at him and saw a guy that I thought was better than me. I never thought that. And I actually thought that was Joe.
I came in with Joe Gilliam, and I was just amazed to see this skinny kid throw this football. I could not believe his talent.
I did not understand the ramifications of who I was and what I was doing and what I represented as being the first.
Being the first for Gilliam meant receiving tons of hate mail and having his life threatened.
Well, you know, we're going to cut your dick off. We're going to kill you and your nigger family, that kind of thing. I carried 5 or 6 guns all the time.
It got so bad that I thought Joey was soon to be dead if he kept abusing drugs like he was. And so I wrote a column telling people that we should still stop giving Joey money, that all Joey was doing, that mostly what Joey was doing was using the money to buy drugs, and that we were helping to kill him.
Battling drugs, Gilliam mounted a comeback to the NFL, but it never happened. Gilliam became a full-time junkie living on the streets of Nashville, Tennessee. It was the low point of his life.
If it's real cold, I seek some temporary shelter, a building, a store, stay for a few minutes, warm up, keep walking, stay up, especially if it's real, real cold. I'm not going to lay down. If it gets real cold, I keep moving.
I hear people say, boy, you ought to be sitting up there with Bradshaw on TV. I'm where I'm supposed to be.
It was a bad time because I was conscious and aware of what I was doing. And what I did was beg, panhandle, that was the lowest I'd gotten.
Major, major, raise the blazer, brain and train ya. The way I'm living, forgiven, what I'm giving up. X on the flex, giving now.
Gilliam could have been the first African-American to win a Super Bowl well before Doug Williams in 1988. One is left to wonder what could have been.
He easily could have been him instead of me. He absolutely had what it takes to have led the Steelers to the Super Bowl. He gave me my job back. I didn't earn it back. That's another thing. I didn't beat him out.